Keep them closed. Okay. Open it.
Feel bad. I don't know how it costs you.
I don't want you to cost you.
No. Do I get to take this one off?
No. Are you expecting something?
Steve?
I need your help.
You want some more?
Oh, yes, please.
No problem.
So you guys live here together?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's great. Where did you meet? Law school?
I still have a year left.
Oh, okay. That's great.
Do you want any food or anything?
No.
Hey, Sarah, why don't you go upstairs and put some clothes on and just give us a minute to catch up a little bit?
Okay. I'm gonna go take a shower. It's nice to meet you, Stephen.
Nice to meet you too. Thanks for the water.
You're welcome.
One more?
No.
What's up, man? You look like shit.
Thank you. I tried to dress up for you.
It's been like 3 years?
And five.
5 years.
Yeah.
Wow. What are you doing all the way out here?
I came to see you.
Me?
Yeah. Do you believe in God?
Oh, shit.
What?
Yeah. That's what you want to ask me?
No, I just... No, I'm sorry, I didn't have to... But do you?
Sure. Yeah. I guess.
So you believe in heaven and hell?
I don't know. Is that why you came all the way out of here?
No, I just... Your wife is nice.
Yeah, she she's great. We're trying to have a baby.
Seriously?
It's a plan.
Tonight you were drawing?
It's deep.
I'm sorry about that.
It's all right. Hey man, tell me, what's going on with you?
I heard you were a cop. Detective or something?
Detective, no. I'm a cop though, yeah. I think I should go.
Go where? Why? Just kind of...
Well, I mean, you've got this new life and a very pretty wife, and you want to have a baby, and I don't know. You don't need me coming in and messing up your life, so I think I'm just going to go.
Not like that, man. I'm the same guy. You need me, I'm here.
And yeah, I need your help.
All right, anything.
I need you to come with me.
Okay, where are we
going? I can't tell you.
Okay.
I don't even know this guy. You know Steve.
He's my college roommate with you.
Liz, fantastic.
You know Steve.
If you want to wait.
I've talked about him.
This guy comes in here in the middle of the night, looking like God knows what, and smelling like that? You haven't talked to him in 5 years and you're just gonna take off at his first call?
He needs my help.
Everybody always needs your help.
Sarah.
Is this about tonight?
Not tonight.
Looks like you're looking for an excuse to take off.
Yeah. Yeah, I called up Steve. And wish him a Merry Christmas and told him to come rescue me from a night of sex with my wife. Come on. Don't be silly.
You said that you were ready. You said you were ready. We were gonna try.
I am ready. Okay, I didn't think it was gonna be the minute after Christmas ended. I mean, we said after the holidays.
When's it gonna be then? Because first you said it was right after you graduated, and then it was right after we found a place, so when now?
I need to do this. Sarah, I need to do this. Okay, when I come back, we will make our beautiful baby boy.
By boy, you mean girl, right?
Appreciate this, man.
Yeah, man, no problem.
So, how'd you get off the leash? Your lady, how'd you convince her to let you go with me?
Huh. I just told her the truth.
Told her your sex change didn't take, so you need somebody to take you to the ER.
That's funny.
No, I just told her you needed my help.
Did she believe that?
Come on, man, look at you. Showing up at our place in the middle of the night.
Before, when you used to help me out all the time, I never forgot about that. I want you to know that I appreciate your help.
Yeah, well, you turned out all right.
Yeah, sure.
I'm good, man. Hey, how's it going? Excuse me. You know, your soda machine's broken.
I don't know.
I'll just get a bottle. Too hard.
You too.
We all set? What'd you get?
Bunch of attitude. I'm gonna Yelp the shit out of this place.
They Yelp gas stations?
Yeah, you could Yelp anything.
I'm sorry.
Just shut up.
I just...
Shut the fuck up.
So have you guys thought of any baby names?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Andy.
What does that even mean? There's a body in the trunk.
It means there's a body in the trunk.
Guy.
Just, you know what?
I don't want to know. Fuck, Steve.
Steve, you're a cop.
Yeah, I know. I just...
No, you don't know.
Yeah, I do know. Look, I didn't plan this. It just happened. And I thought of you, and I thought, oh, man, you could help me out, and I just...
Why would you think of me? I haven't seen you in 5 years, and you show up to my place with this.
Why, you just... I'm sorry.
Crazy. Are you... I'm gonna have a family. What am I...
What are you... Yeah, I mean, I didn't know.
Oh, my...
I'm sorry, okay?
Stop fucking saying you're
sorry. All right,
sorry.
All right.
Just stop it.
All right.
What is it you think I can do? I'm not a coroner, Steve.
Well, I don't need a coroner, okay? I need someone to help me get rid of this. I mean, you don't have to help. I thought you would. I don't know why I thought that. I just thought you would. And if you don't want to, that's fine. I can take you home or I can drop you off. Steve, it doesn't matter. I gotta get rid of this body, all right?
This is why we're driving here. Middle of nowhere to bury this. Anyway.
Yeah. I mean, I thought that was obvious. I just thought that was obvious. Why else would we be here? I'm sorry, but I gotta get rid of this body. And if you don't want to help, I can take you home or whatever, but...
See, we gotta... You don't even have shovels. You don't even have shovels. How do you get through your life?
What was it?
6732. Thank you. Come on, Andy. You haven't said anything for hours, man. You can't take the silent treatment. I mean, tell me you hate me or, like, I shouldn't have come. Just say something, anything. Just talk. I'm scared, Andy, all right? I'm so scared. Fine, don't fucking talk to me. I said I was sorry, alright? I'm sorry. I mean it.
Simon.
What?
It's a boy. Simon.
What if it's a girl?
Mary.
Mary? That's your mom's name. Huh. Yeah, Mary's nice. That's a beautiful name. You think if, you think when Simon or Mary come, you think I'd be able to come meet them? Or meet a godfather? I could do that. I'm just joking. Just a joke. I like those names. Simon. Simon says. Yeah, that would be cool.
Thank you. Get up.
Ah.
I don't believe we've been properly introduced. Manners, huh? Well, this is pathetic. You ask my partner. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. You can't, because we just buried him.
Partner, you... No. No, you...
I'm gonna bash your fucking skull in the way I did Steve's.
What's going on here? I don't understand.
What's going on here is that you just stabbed an officer during the arrest for the murder of his partner. Juries, they don't much like cop killers.
Shut up.
Who are you?
Give me the keys.
How do you know Stevie?
The keys.
Why did he come to you?
I said, give me the keys.
Or you'll what?
Hey.
Andy. You have a cute little knife there. But I hurt people. I hurt a lot of people. Now, you're a real good runner. Maybe you ran track in high school, a little in college. You were really winded in the woods out there. Figure you go to the gym once a week. You work too much. You're a banker. You look like a lawyer. Andy, you're gonna die today. But I need some answers before I can give you that. I told you, I hurt people! If you're not gonna talk to me, I'll find someone who will.
license and registration, please. What was that noise?
Be out in a minute.
Better hurry, man. Just calling a cop.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm sorry to bother you guys. I was wondering if maybe you could help me out.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I was in a car accident, hit and run. You know, they totaled my car, but I'm all right. I just had to walk for 2 miles to get here.
It's terrible.
Yeah. Anyway, I was wondering if maybe you could give me a ride up into town. I, left my wallet in the car, so...
That's okay. No. I'm Dan. This is Melissa.
Greg.
Yeah, it's good to meet you, Greg. Jump on in.
Do you need to call anyone?
What?
Do you need to, like, let anyone know that you're coming, or...
Sarah, it's me. I'm just checking in, let you know I'm coming home. Can't promise I'll see you soon.
Voicemail.
Yeah.
So where are you coming from?
Excuse me?
You said you promised you were coming home, so it kind of sounded like you'd been gone a while. It sounded kind of romantic.
Melissa, leave him alone.
What?
I'm sorry, she's nosy.
Sure. It feels like it's been a long time, it's just been a day.
See? Romantic.
Where are you coming from?
Just up here helping a friend now.
Did you? Did you, help him?
I'm fine. I just need to close my eyes for a little bit.
Some sad news is that local police officer Juliet Fraley was found dead on picked up in Spring Road this morning, having been shot dead last night while on duty. Police are on the lookout for a Hispanic man, approximately 6 feet tall, with brown hair, brown eyes, and a goatee, who was seen earlier today covered in blood at Barnett's Diner. Witnesses say his arm may be broken, and currently the police do not know if he is armed, but should be considered extremely dangerous. If you have any information, police are asking to please call your local police department or 911. So be safe out there, people. And now back to the hit.
Hey, Greg, how far?
I was there. But it wasn't me. Okay, I wouldn't do that.
Who was it then?
I don't know.
You were there, but you don't know?
I don't know his name.
Why didn't you call the police?
No. No police.
What are you gonna do with us?
Do you have any change? Hey, Sarah, I'm coming. Who is?
Trying to figure it out, right? Does he know she's here? Did he wake her up? Did he touch her? Don't worry. Nobody touched her. You should teach your girlfriend nothing good ever comes knocking at the door after midnight. And tell her, every little thing's gonna be alright.
Sarah, everything's gonna be okay.
I know what you're thinking. Man, we sure got a lot of mileage out of that roll of tape.
Just please let us go.
Go where? Beautiful here. Why would you want to leave? Such a nice house. So far away from anyone.
Help!
Nothing. I'm sorry. Am I keeping you from something? Do you have an appointment to keep or perhaps more graves to dig?
I told you. We thought you were dead. I don't even know who you are.
Thank you for telling me that. Makes me feel better when I think about my funeral.
No eulogy. No beautiful woman who loves me, dressed in black mourning, holding that single black rose, crying as the parishioners tear her hands from the casket. None of that. Just me. But you would be there, of course. Two shovels and a hole. I think that sort of makes us family, Andrew. I might get all choked up.
Why don't you tell me who you are?
I'm a cop, remember? Oh, no. I figured that out. I'm not a cop. I'm not dead. So what does that leave? Maybe I'm just bored. Tell me, Andrew. What do you want to be when you grow up? Andrew, the man with the gun is asking you a question. Remember, we're family now. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Father.
What's that?
I said a father.
A father. Andrew. No, I don't see it. I've known you for a good long day now, and I just don't think you have the genes for it. Look at your arm. So lifeless, hanging against your body. Weak. Your face. It's all purpley, swollen. Sorry, I don't see it. Now, Sarah. Ah, oh, pretty Sarah. She's got the right parts for it. I may have peeked once or twice at the gift before I wrapped her and put her under the tree. I have an idea. How about I do you a solid and be sort of a surrogate for you? You know, you can still pick at the weeds, but I'll plant the foundation. Andrew, how would you like to raise my son?
Little bitch up so you don't run away. I'm gonna ask you once. Why did you try and bury me?
Steve thought you were dead.
Steve thought I was dead. Why did he come to you?
Because my friend.
Should we close his eyes?
No. No, we need to know.
Who was he?
Christmas that for me. Very kind.
Hey, Bill, what'd you sleep in your car?
I must have overslept.
Usual?
Yeah. Thing is, I seem to have misplaced my wallet.
Come on, Bill, you know you stole out from last night.
I got it. Merry Christmas.
Thanks.
Two of Bill's usuals.
Coming right up.
Want some?
No. Thanks for the drinks, though.
Maybe later. How much?
It's on the house.
No. I wouldn't dream of it. Here, give the change.
It's mighty generous.
Well, it's not my money. Enjoy it.
Two more. Cause of and solution to. Am I right?
Bill. No. He's right. Hey, make it four. I'm good for it.
Be my new best friend.
Oh, Bill, I believe I'm your only friend.
What the hell is this?
I'm buying you drinks.
With my own money? This is my wallet.
See, that's where you're wrong, Willie. You don't own anything anymore. See, this is what happens when you don't pay your debts. No, thank you.
Sure you don't want decaf?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
Just give me a holler if you change mine.
Yeah. Oh, do you have sugar?
It's right there on your table, sweetie.
Sorry. Thank you. Oh, I see why you picked this place, little minx.
Yeah. You know, I don't get paid for mileage, though. Something to keep in mind for next time.
Next time? No, they said this was it. My debt is cleared.
Okay, cool down. There's no need to make a big deal here, all right? You've been a good boy. Your debt's cleared. I need you to do one more little thing for me.
Wait, what?
Can I get you, darling?
Well, hello. Aren't you sweeter than a peach in a pie?
If that's your way of ordering pie, we've only got cherry.
I like cherry. However, I think I'm in the mood for something sweeter tonight.
Like what?
I don't know. How about me and you go in the back and show me some of your inventory?
Wow.
I don't understand.
I know.
Give someone a compliment?
No, we had a deal.
We still have a deal.
Sweetheart, coffee, please. Who's this guy?
Lawyer? Corporate? Nobody?
What did he do?
He made friends with the wrong people. Unfortunate circumstances, wrong place, wrong time.
What does that mean? He didn't do anything?
She's so sweet, isn't she? He made some bad decisions. You know, sometimes you don't see things happen, even though they're coming right at you. This guy, this lawyer, he thought he made all the right decisions. Graduated from college, went to law school, then he passed the bar. And he got a good job, a good law firm. He was so excited. He brought in a big client. It's good, right? He thought he made all the right decisions. They rewarded him by sending him down here to our little neck of the woods to oversee the new client's contracts. What he doesn't realize is that they should have used more local, trusted contractors. Individually, every little decision was perfect. However, when you put them together, he works for the wrong law firm. He has the wrong client. He made wrong friends who made all the wrong decisions. They crossed the wrong people. Put him in deep woods. He doesn't even know it. He has no idea about the bad decisions he's made.
Sure like to hear yourself talk, huh?
Yeah. I think it's what makes me good company.
So what's gonna happen to this guy?
I need you to get me his name and his address. I won't talk your ear off with all the details. Now, Stephen,
you to make a smart decision here. Okay. This is the last one. Steven, don't forget to tip the waitress. She was very good.